curtains near the station.
Pleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage. Next, let's talk about stimuli. Stimulus that elicits pain are called as noxious stimuli or nociceptive stimuli. Now, let's talk about the receptors. There are two types of nociceptors, A delta receptors and polymodal C receptors.
Pain pathways. Paleospinothalamic pathway. Phylogenetically, paleospinothalamic is the oldest pathway. This pathway mainly carries the sensation of slow pain.
A slow conducting multineuron system that mediates the poly localized pain from deep somatic and visceral structures. The fibers are mostly C fibers. First order neurons. First order neurons enter the spinal cord and terminate mainly in the lamina 2 of the dorsal arm. Second order neurons. Second order neurons decrease and ascend up in the contralateral spinothalamic pathway. The fibers are more medially placed in the spinothalamic tract. In the brainstem on the way to thalamus, fibers project to three major nuclear groups forming three subsystems. Third order neurons. In the thalamus, the fibers terminate mainly in the major nuclear group, that is the midline and intralamina nuclei.
New spinothalamic pathway.
The new spinothalamic tract is mostly developed in the premens. This pathway carries mainly the fast pain. The fibers are mostly A delta fibers, first order neurons. First order of neurons terminate mainly in the lamina 1 and 5 in the dorsal arm of spinal cord. Second order neurons. Second order neurons cross over to the opposite side in the same segment of spinal cord and ascend in the lateral spinothalamic tract. In the spinal cord, there is topographic organization of fibers. The fibers from lower body parts are placed laterally and fibers from upper body parts are located more medially. Third order neurons. The third order of neurons originate from specific thalamic nuclei
and project to the four central gyrus, that is the sensory cortex.
Why is he here again? Hey, are you back again? Okay, let's go to the general physician.
find it like that way. So your pulse seems to be normal. I've checked for fractures and also insect bites, and it all seems normal happening. But for further checking, maybe you can take them to the orthopedician by taking the X-ray. If you visit them, I think things will be good.
Hey, aren't you like got a vacation? What happened? Why don't you consult me? I'm a cardiologist, so like I feel like I can say something. I can give you some ideas.
Oh.
Yeah, I have a
So he had a femur fracture 6 months back, and now he has pain radiating from his left shoulder towards his left arm.
Take an ECG and 2 days ago immediately, and make sure you follow up with the patient and come meet me after the report.
So students, we have a case right over here of a 44-year-old who has suggestive signs of myocardial infarction and has pain radiating from her left shoulder to the breastbone and to the pit of her stomach. So you'll get to know more about this case throughout this lecture. So we'll start with what is referred pain. So referred pain is basically a phenomenon wherein pain in the visceral structure is felt in the somatic structure owing to the absence of pain receptors in the viscera. So the mechanism behind referred pain is that you'll have visceral pain fibers synapsing with the second order neuron of the lateral spinothalamic tract, thereby creating an illusion that the pain is originating from the somatic structure. So now, the localization of this pain is on the basis of the dermatomal segment from which the visceral organ once originated. That is basically the dermatomal theory. For example, in the case of heart, all the visceral nerve fibers enter the spinal cord between the segments C3 and T5. This is owing to its dermatomal origin. Therefore, any somatic nerve fiber entering the spinal cord through these segments is mistook for the site of origin of pain.